In this lesson, we'll start installing the iTwin viewer and configure it to point to our iModel. Now that we have our development environment ready with Node.js, we can start installing our iTwin viewer. I have Visual Studio Code opened up already, and we'll need a terminal open to start using NPX. So if you're using Visual Studio Code like me, you can just go to the top tab here and click on New Terminal. I'm going to be creating the project in my home directory, so where I'm at currently is fine. To get the project started, we'll need to create our React app template. And to avoid unnecessary typos, I'm going to go to developer.bentley.com. Under the Learning tab at the top here, go to Tutorials, and click on the first tile, Start Building a Viewer App. Again, this lesson is just going through this tutorial, so if you miss anything, all the information can be found here. Go past Set Up Your Environment, which we've already done, and go to Get the Code. And on the right side of here, you'll see a copy command. Hit copy, go back to your Visual Code terminal, paste that right in, and all you'll want to do is change the your app name to whatever you want. I'm going to name this to Smart House iTwin Viewer. Once that's done, go ahead and hit enter, and this will create your Node environment, install all the necessary packages, and provide a code template for you. So we'll return once the directory has been created. Now that everything has finished setting up, let's open the directory in Visual Studio Code. We'll need to go to the file Open Explorer at the top left and select Open Folder, navigating to the Smart House iTwin Viewer directory that we created earlier with the npx command, and select Folder. This should open up the directory up in Visual Studio Code. The install should have everything set up for us already. We now only need to point our viewer to the iModel we created. So checking out the file explorer on the left, there's a .env file here. With the .env file now opened, there are a few environment variables we need to fill out to get authorization working and the viewer pointing to our iModels. We'll first start by populating our IMJS iTwin ID and IMJS iModel ID to let the viewer know which iModel you want it to target. We can retrieve these through developer.bentley.com, and on your profile at the top right here, give that a click and go ahead and click on My iModels. Go back to our Visual Code and paste that right underneath. You can remove the above two empty iTwin ID and iModel ID here, and now we have our viewer pointing to our iModel. Give that a save. And we now want to fill out our authorization client to handle logins. And to fill this out, we need to first create a client by going back to developer.bentley.com. And again, under the first tutorial, you'll want to scroll down to step number 3. Under Register an Application and hit Register. For this tutorial, we're not manually creating it, we're just automatically creating a single page application. If you'd like to know more about the different types of application, I encourage you to give this page a read and learn more about the types of clients you can create. But for now, once this has automatically generated, you can go ahead and click Copy here, going back to our Visual Code. Right under scopes, I'm going to paste this right in. Do not delete IMJS auth authority, but we can delete the old empty variables here. Give that a save. And this should provide all the environment variables we need to get our iTwin viewer started with login and pointing to our iTwin ID and iModel ID. Now, jumping back to our terminal, all we need to do is run npm run start. Let that build, and it will automatically kick off the iTwin viewer in the browser. So we'll let this run for a bit. Once it's completed loading, you'll see an icon here. If you aren't logged in, it will prompt in for a login. and also require you to allow some scopes that you've requested in the .env file. And all you have to do is hit approval from there. You'll notice the iTwin IDs were the IDs that we provided in the .env file, the iModel ID and the iTwin ID, and you'll see our smart house model right here. At this point, we're ready to move on and start coding and customizing our iTwin viewer.